Last we discussed how to make a cross in pea plants. So before considering the experiments in pea plants, we shall discuss some genetic terms which we are using in this topic. So the first term we are using is alleles. So alleles, they are genes that code for a pair of contrasting characters. So this is the meaning of alleles, right? So alleles are genes that code for a pair of contrasting characters. So as I said, these are genes, right? So normally you find a pair, right? A pair of genes. So we shall consider this pair, right? Capital T and small t. So here we can consider capital T as a gene or a allele. Similarly, small t, it is also a allele, right? So these are genes. These are genes that code for a pair of contrasting characters. Here contrasting means opposite, right? Now here this capital T, it codes for a character that is called tall. Small t, it codes for a character called dog, right? So tall and dog, what is this tall and dog? Tall and dog is a pair of contrasting characters which are observed in pea plants, right? So this pair of genes, they code for this pair of contrasting characters. That's why this pair of genes, it is called alleles, right? So here capital T is one, capital T is one allele, small t is another allele, or we can call it as a gene. Got it? So this is a pair of genes that code, means they control a pair of contrasting characters, where capital T controls tallness, small t controls dwarfness. So you may expect a one mark question, what are alleles? So this answer you'll write. Followed? The next, we shall consider homozygous. Homozygous organism, or another term used is homozygote. So what is this homozygous organism? It is an organism which is having a pair of similar genes for a particular character. Right? Homozygous organism has a pair of similar genes for a particular character. Now similar genes means both the genes or the alleles are same. Now for example, so here capital T represents one gene or one allele, small t represents one gene. So how many genes are here? There are two genes, means there are a pair of genes, right? So both the genes are, both the genes are similar, that is they are same, or they are identical, right? Identical, similar, same. So here we can call these genes as homozygous. Homo, here homo means same, right? So if an organism or a pea plant, if it has these genes, then we can call that pea plant as homozygous pea plant, or simply we can call it as homozygote. Then similarly, heterozygous organism or heterozygous organism or heterozygote. Now, what do you mean by this heterozygous organism? Here, hetero. Hetero means different or dissimilar. So, the meaning of heterozygote. Dissimilar genes. So, heterozygous organism is an organism which is having dissimilar genes for a particular character. So, dissimilar means the genes are not identical. Now, for example, so we shall consider this pair of genes. So, you have one is capital T, another one is small t. Right? So, one is capital, one is small. So, they are not same. But here in this case, this is capital, this is also capital T. So, both the genes are same here. That in that pair, both the genes are same. Right? Then this is homozygous. In this pair, one is capital, one is small. So, they are not identical or they are not same. So, this condition, we can call it as heterozygous condition. And the organism which is having these similar genes is called heterozygous organism or heterozygote, right? So, one more point I would like to make here. So, we shall consider capital T, right? So, capital T, as I told you, it represents a gene, right? Even small t, it also represents a gene, but both the genes, they are not same, right? So here we can call this capital T as a dominant gene or a dominant allele. Similarly, small t. Small t is a recessive gene or a recessive allele, right? So here dominant, what is the meaning of dominant? In simple words, we can say dominant means something which is strong, right, or powerful. Recessive, opposite of strong is weak. So, recessive means weak, which is not strong, right? So, dominant and recessive, they are opposite words, right? So, similarly, strong and weak, they are opposite words. So, just remember, dominant means strong, recessive means weak, right? So, capital T, it is a stronger gene, right? It is a stronger gene. Small t, it is a weaker gene, right? So next, we shall consider next we shall consider dominant trait. Now what do you mean by this term dominant trait? So dominant trait is a trait that is controlled by a dominant gene. Right? Dominant trait is a trait controlled by a dominant gene. Similarly, recessive trait So trait can be a character, right? So recessive trait is a trait controlled by a recessive gene. So here gene can be also called as a factor, right? So dominant gene or a dominant factor. So how you can define a dominant factor or a dominant gene? So this is the meaning of a dominant factor or a dominant gene. So it is a gene in a pair which is expressed. Now you consider a pair of genes, right? So in this pair of genes, capital T and small t, which is the dominant gene or dominant factor? The one which is expressed. Right, so I will clarify this. Now see, imagine a pea plant which is having these genes for a particular character. Which character? That particular character is stem height. So to control stem height, a pea plant has these genes, right? A pair of genes to control stem height. Now in this, as you know, capital T is a dominant gene or dominant allele. Small t is a recessive allele. Now this pea plant will exhibit which character with respect to stem height? So either this plant has to be tall or it has to be dwarf. Dwarf means short, right? So the stem of this plant, it has to be either tall or dwarf. So can you tell me now whether the stem is tall or dwarf? So here the stem will be tall, right? So the pea plant which is having these genes will produce tall stem, right? It will produce a tall stem. Now tallness is controlled by which genes? Out of two genes, which gene controls this tall character? So it is controlled by capital T. So tallness is a character controlled by this capital T or a dominant gene, right? Which character is controlled by this small t? Small t controls dwarfness. Right? Small t controls a character called dwarfness. Capital T controls a character called tallness. Right? So tallness, that is tall stem, is mainly because of this dominant gene capital T. Dwarf stem is because of this recessive gene small. Now here in this pair, one is dominant gene and one is recessive gene. Now this plant will produce a character called tall or tallness because capital T is dominant and it is expressed. Expressed means the character controlled by capital T is observed in the offspring or a plant, right? Now this plant is showing tallness, that means capital T is expressed. Small t is not expressed, so you don't find dwarf stem, right? So we say small t is suppressed. So just remember, expressed and suppressed, they are opposite terms, right? So here capital T is expressed in this pair, small t is suppressed, right? So because of that, that plant will produce tall stem, right? Then next we shall consider recessive trait. So recessive trait, right? So not trait, recessive factor. So what is this recessive factor or a recessive gene or a recessive allele? So this is the meaning of recessive factor. So recessive factor or recessive gene is a gene in a pair which is suppressed, right? Or which is not expressed. Then we can call that gene or a factor as recessive factor. Again, say, so these are a pair of genes, right? So here small t is a recessive factor. Why? Because this plant will produce a character that is called tall. Tall is controlled by capital T, right? So capital T is expressed. But here this plant will not produce dwarf stem because small t is suppressed or it is not expressed. So such genes in a pair, right, which are not expressed or which are suppressed, we can call them as recessive factors, right? So in this video we have discussed some of the terms, right? So one term that we discussed was alleles, right? Then we discussed the next one, that is homozygous organism. Then we discussed heterozygous organism, right? After that we discussed dominant trait, recessive trait, then a dominant factor, recessive factor. So I hope you have understood the meaning of all these terms that we have discussed today, right? So just remember, alleles, these are genes that code for a pair of contrasting characters, right? Then similarly, homozygous organism or homozygote. So it is an organism having similar genes for a particular character. Then heterozygous organism or heterozygote. So this is an organism which is having dissimilar genes for a particular character, right? Then dominant factor. So dominant factor is a dominant gene, right? So this gene in a pair, it is expressed, right? So gene in a pair which is expressed, it is called dominant factor. Then opposite is recessive factor, right? So recessive factor means it is a gene in a pair which is suppressed or not expressed, right? Then dominant character or dominant trait. So what is this dominant character or dominant trait? The trait or character controlled by a dominant gene, right? Then similarly, the recessive trait or recessive character. So the character that is controlled by recessive genes, right? It can be called as a recessive character or recessive trait, right? So with this, we shall conclude this video, right? So just go through it, see this video once again, write down the points, try to understand, and we shall continue in the next video.